thus the station of Sialkot in the Punjab, the daily through train from Wazirabad arrives behind an elderly British 440 built for the Northwest Frontier Railway in 1900. The train used to go to Jammu, the only railway station in Kashmir, but since partition has been diverted to Chakamroo. This M-class 440 locomotive is typical of the splendid relics of the British Empire, which can still be seen at work all over the railways of the Indian subcontinent. Despite their antiquated appearance, these little engines were built as late as 1931 by the Yorkshire Engine Company of Sheffield. Four engines were built for the line, and they are maintained at the depot of Shantipoor, which somehow keeps them going despite an obvious lack of facilities. The afternoon train for Krishnagar sets out from Shantipoor as the driver smiles tolerantly at his visitor's camera. The track is a bit rough in places, but generally the ride is smoother than expected, certainly a great improvement over the rival bus service on the potholed road that parallels the railway. Political slogans and sacred cows are typical of the wayside stations, as are the non-fare paying passengers. Krishnagar is a busy junction where passengers from upcountry change for the electric train to Calcutta, and passengers from Calcutta wait for their connections on the narrow gauge. The narrow gauge train from Shantipur continues its journey to the terminus of the line at Nabadwiska on the banks of the Ganges. of the HPS class leaves Krishnagar for Lalgola. At the next platform, another HPS class engine with a train from Lalgola to Calcutta pulls smartly away, although most of its passengers have already changed to the preceding electric train. The journey on the railways of Bengal in 1971 was often a melancholy affair, since this was the period of the Bangladesh War of Independence, and the crowds of people at the stations were not passengers, but homeless refugees. The once proud East Bengal Railway, the main link for the tea trade between Assam and Calcutta, has for years been truncated at the wayside border station of Geddi, about 60 miles from Calcutta. Geddi station has become a refugee camp, where there is nothing to do except queue up for rice and stare at visitors. Or look at British-built suburban 264 tanks of the early 50s running round their train for the return trip to Ranagat. Howrah station in Calcutta is one of the best places to see Indian steam. Classic British type 060 goods engines of the SGC class, dating from 1905, can be seen shunting all day long. Then there are the modern WP class Pacifics like this one, backing down to its train in Howrah terminus. The first of these engines were supplied by American and Canadian builders in 1947 and 48. After a few years, the Indians built their own. There are now over 400 in service on major expresses throughout India. The most common broad-gauge locomotive in India is the WG-class mixed traffic 282, built in large numbers by American and British builders in the late 40s, and later, like the WP, built by India herself. In typical grubby condition, surprising in a labour-intensive country like India, the WG here is hauling a rake of old steam carriages as a last-minute substitution for a failed electric suburban train. The HPS class 460, built by the Vulcan Foundry in England in 1925, is still a common sight at Howrah station and is used on most of the semi-fast trains on non-electrified lines. With their classic English proportions, these engines represent pure nostalgia for the British enthusiasts.